strokes forward for him and an administration to work in harmony with the RRA. And we're excited about this opportunity. I think it's a great time in the city. A lot of revitalization, a lot of projects are starting to emerge. So the mayor and the administration are very excited to work with RRA as being an important partner in that process. So as I shared before in previous meetings, my role is to be that liaison at times between the administration and the board. So I try to attend as many meetings as I can to offer input, to listen, and provide feedback. So we're just excited to be part of that process. So that's pretty much, you know, the general comments there.
Okay. Well, I you know, for myself, from the board, I want to thank the mayor and his team, the managing director, you know, and down to even Public Works, police chief. As everybody knows, we had some issues down at the riverfront property, where basically they were trashing our property. We worked together collaboratively to devise a plan to clean up down there, and it seems like it's working. And we want to thank the administration for that. Also, you know, without a doubt, I think this administration by far has wanted to work collaboratively with all of its stakeholders, both in government and the community. And I think that just should be recognized. You know, evidence today in the paper, the police chief, you know, police department announced that there were some people, you know, given tickets and stuff, citations for dumping basically down along the river in one spot. You know, and I think over in Spring Street in another spot. So, you know, it's along with his clean initiative, and you know, we look forward to working with him on that end, and you know, we look forward to a good relationship going forward. So if you can just convey that to the mayor, I'd appreciate it.
I definitely will. Thank you for your remarks.
Okay. Is that it, Frank?
Yeah, that's it at the moment, unless there's other items on that are on the agenda down the road. I don't have the agenda in front of me, but I mean, that's, if there's any other stuff, you know, if you want me to weigh in later, that's fine.
Anybody else have any comments for the chief of staff or the mayor?
No.
No, we just want to thank them all for the great job and collaboration with everything that they're doing with us in regards to cleaning up the city.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. So, Denny, there's no emails or written statements?
No.
Okay, good. Moving on to the chairman's report, I sent out the chairman's report. I try to do this to condense, you know, all of what can be said in a meeting so we don't have 3-hour meetings. So if you have any recommendations, what should go in my report, I'd appreciate it. But, you know, it's fairly straightforward. I just give dates and times and, you know, what is said, you know, that's pertinent to our organization. So the salient points here, there was an issue with a sidewalk down in front of 645 Penn Street, where the owner of the building thought that sidewalk was, you know, redevelopment authority property. So in going back and looking through the deeds, and then talking with the engineer who is the recipient of the surveyor who was the recipient of the original survey, we determined that the sidewalk indeed was a right-of-way and actually belonged to the city, but per city ordinance, Keith, you can correct me if I'm wrong, the property owner is responsible for that.
Right.
Okay. So, as I stated before, we met with Pedro Cortez and Keith's staff about the issue down at the riverfront, and I feel firm that I can report back to the board that you know, it's working down there. And I was remiss in saying that also the parking authority was part of that, you know, giving warnings down there and citations. We did not want to be heavy-handed, but at the same time, we did not want our property destroyed. And of course, you can hear motorcycles running by here up and down the street, but And we didn't want, you know, any sort of injuries. So I feel affirmed that the city administration is taking care of that. I think looking forward to that, forward on that property down at the river that we own, we want to look at DCNR, the Department of Community and Natural Resources with the state, and see if there are any grants, whether it be education, facilities, upgrades, or whatever. And I think we want to try to look at making that a destination, because I look at it as economic development. We have people coming into the city and utilizing an area. And when you're talking 500, 600, 700, up to 1,000 people, that's dollars coming to our city. And we know, because I've went down there myself and talked to people, many of them are not here. So they're coming in, and we need to gain that resource and utilize it, and you know, make the best of it. At the same time, educating them that they just can't, you know, come in and destroy things. So so I think we should do that. I'll work with the city there and see if the grant coordinator with the city can look into that for us, because we do not have a grant person ourselves. So I will be doing that going forward. As you may have seen in the paper, Governor Tom Wolf's office announced the grant that was coming forward from the state for environmental remediation over there in the Buttonwood Gateway West project. They're going to be building about 40 dwellings over there. If I'm correct, Keith, is that 40 dwellings or 40 houses?
It's apartment units.
Apartment units, okay. So that's a really good upgrade for that area of town down there between Gordon Street and Top Hawkins Street. I actually, as a kid, well, as a young man, my son's mother lived down in the 400 block there of Gordon Street, 433. And back in that day, it was actually a good neighborhood, back in the early 80s. And, you know, it kind of got run down, but, you know, we're redeveloping that. You know, what we're here for, we're working to redevelop that with our partner, Delaware Valley Development Corporation. I did receive some complaints about our property up there at 824 and 842 Penn Street. Tremendous amount of drunkenness, disorderly behavior, drug activity. I've been told there's been overdoses up there, urination, and, you know, the whole nine yards. And I did go up there and inspect the area myself. And I can tell you, I've been a lot of places in this country and this world. The amount of drug paraphernalia that was there is unbelievable. But again, the administration is working with us. We're going to have some meetings going forward and to bring in the stakeholders in that block, specifically Family Dollar and the Berks Health Center. And we're going to reach out to some other stakeholders within that neighborhood there to try to kind of work together and devise a plan, you know, along with public safety. You know, our partners at Council on Chemical Abuse, because there's a lot of stuff going on there, and you can't arrest your way out of those kinds of problems. You know, people need treatment, they need help. Some of them are homeless. So we're just going to be meeting and devising a plan going forward to address that. Denny and myself met with the city auditor this week to, was that this week or last week? No, it was eight.
Last Thursday.
So we met with the city auditor. The board authorized me to take our finances to the city auditor, and I expect she will be reporting back to us in September. I don't see preliminarily any major issues. It's just a matter of bringing it all together and tying it together. So basically, that's my report. I can say also that Vice Chair Santana and I, Mr. Wellington, are going to be meeting with Parking Authority next Thursday, the 27th, to discuss the possibility of sale of some property that they are interested in. Also, I want to say that I think that we need to work to clean up our inventory. We have a lot of things in our inventory, meaning property that we own, that are, say, sidewalks, that really a long time ago should have been conveyed to the properties that they went with. And specifically this, what I'm talking to is the parking authority. Right next to parking authority garages, we actually own some sidewalks. Now keep in mind, there's two things there. One, somebody falls on there, you know, then we have issues. And most importantly, we're wasting money paying for insurance for things that we really shouldn't have in our inventory. So I intend to clean that up, not just with parking authority, but I think there are some other properties that can be conveyed to nearby properties. So we're going to be evaluating that going forward. That's it basically for my chairman's report. Is there any questions or comments there?
Yes, quick question in regards to the listing of the properties that we have. How can we get a hold of that? Like that we can try to dissect each property individually to see if it's feasible to get rid of them, sell them, or find some good use for them.
I have an entire list, almost it's like a book of all the properties. I don't know if I sent that to you when you first joined, but I can do that and I can send it to Mr. Fleming as well.
Well, let's get that out.
You can send it, or if there's actually a book, I could pick it up or whatever.
I'll email it to you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Denny, can you email that to everybody on the board?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. So then going forward, then we can kick back and forth. We can each peruse it and see, you know, the other way to find out where in proximity these properties are, if, you know, you can either go out and look around, or you can go on the Berks County assessment site once you get the list, Wellington,
yes,
and then see what's right next door to it. It makes sense to, you know, in this case, I'll just say the parking authority, to convey those properties. I don't really think there's an expectation of any kind of, for a small sidewalk of us getting anything for that, in my opinion anyway. You guys may feel differently, but we'll talk about that when we get closer to that.
Sure.
So, Denny, you'll get that out then to the board?
Sure.
Okay, cool.
Now, how updated is that listing?
As of last year, we haven't purchased anything since.
Okay.
I had put that together when our executive director left, because the new board that came in was asking the same questions that you're asking. And that was how our property dispense policy came about, going to dispose of these properties. I put that together. I put pictures in there of each property and the report from the county's website.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay, any more questions or comments for the chairman's report? Hearing none, moving on to new business. We have a resolution before us, Resolution 3-2020, which is a resolution authorizing the city to post prohibitive behavior signs at the riverfront property down there where we've had issues. And they're going to be orange signs. I sent out the green copy of what we had, but they're going to be posted in orange. And the reason I said that is, you know, it's here, I have an orange shirt on. Great. if you tie the orange trash bags that even the police are giving out when they're down there on the riverfront, the police are doing not only enforcement, but they're handing actually trash bags out to people and saying, let's put this in here, let's clean it up and stuff. But the trash bags in color match the signs. So I kind of tried to tie that in to trying to get them, train them to, you know, this is where you need to put it. And, you know, hopefully that'll work. So this is what that resolution does. It just authorizes it. It says that we agree to assist in any prosecution or arrest of anybody down there for the prohibitive behavior. So again, these kinds of rules are not meant to be heavy-handed. They're just meant to be guidance, you know, what is expected when you're on our property. So do I have a motion to approve resolution 3, 2020?
John. I motion that.
So it's been moved by Wellington, seconded by Dr. Pepin.
Yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Next on the new business, I sent an email out to the board about an appropriation to DID. You know, I thought long and hard about this, and I've said all along, even before I got on this board, if you go around and look at our properties, not just the ones that are in the peripheral, but primarily the ones that are in the city's core, DID does a tremendous amount of work there for us. They shovel our snow, they salt, you know, we all know salt can be expensive. They clean up a tremendous amount of debris. They clean up, for all intents and purposes, a lot of crap. And we do not clean up our own property. You know, so there's two ways to go there. I think our property should be clean because our mission statement is to get rid of blight. And if we're not getting rid of blight, then what are we here for? I think this is a cost-effective for us, a cost-effective way to address the issue that we should be addressing anyway. I propose that it is only a one-time appropriation for this year with no expectation in following years. Once we get this organization back up and running as it should as a redevelopment authority, when revenues start to go up, then we can look at looking at maybe appropriating more in future years. But, DID is going to change tremendously. They're having a firm come in and I think doing an RFP or whatever to reevaluate them. And if you've seen their presentation at City Council the other night, they clearly are going to make a change. But I think right now, if we didn't have them downtown, We complain about a lot of trash, and there is a lot of trash downtown. There's a lot of stuff downtown. But if they weren't there at all, can you imagine what that would look like every day? So I asked the board to appropriate, $5,000 as I sent out to the board with no expectation in future years. Now, to appropriate, we can only do what we can do. But I think this right now is going in a good direction and keeping with the mission why we're here. So do I have a motion?
Let me make a comment about that.
Dr. Pepin, let's do this. I introduced what I think we should do in the appropriation. So if we have an emotion and then get a second, then we can enter into discussion. I want to hear what you have to say. I'm just saying if there's not going to be a motion and a second, then I guess we don't talk about it.
Okay. Or,
you know, if we talk about it as a board through email, that's fine. So I ask for a motion now. There is no motion. Okay. All right, we'll talk about this in emails going forward and, see where we go. All right. So we're at the end of our agenda here. Dr. Pepin, you sent me an email. Are you resigning?
Yes.
Okay. All right. I did receive an email today from Dr. Pepin. And he is notifying of us his resignation effective today. And he said it's been an honor to be with the board. So do we have a motion to accept Dr. Pepin's resignation?
I can't hear anybody.
Can I? Oh, yeah.
You hear us now?
Yeah, your mic was. I hear you now. Okay.
You guys sound kind of far.
Okay.
One second.
Can everybody hear me now?
I can hear, yes.
Okay. Okay. All right. So do I have a motion to accept Dr. Pepin's resignation from the board effective today?
I accept.
Okay. Is it seconded? Mr. Fleming, can you hear us?
Yes, I can. I accept.
Okay. So it's been motioned and seconded. Any comments for Mr. Pepin? I will just add that I know Dr. Pepin for quite some time now. He's always been a person who's been out there in the community. He cares about his community. He stepped up, and I think he did a great job. As you know, and I speak from this from experience and other things he's done. I mean, I haven't been here with him that long, but he did stick around long enough to get the board reconstituted so we can move on. So, you know, and I thank you, Dr. Pepin, for that. And I surely appreciate what you have done for this community. And I wish you great endeavors going forward.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you.
Any other comments? I want to mention that working with Dr. Pepin was a great experience. He was on the board before I was, and he was very helpful with me. And instructed me on, you know, on how the board works and everything like that. And, you know, I just wanted to thank him and appreciate all of his efforts that he did for the board there.
It's been a pleasure, Willington.
Mr. Fleming, any comments?
I would like to. I did not have the privilege to meet Dr. Pepin. I feel very unfortunate not to have the ability to talk to him before he ventured out. However, I don't know if it's because Dr. Pepin realized that they have accepted a new member, so he decided to get out.
No.
But Dr. Pepin, I don't know who, I don't think we have met, or maybe we have met and not recognizing who you are. Yeah. But it seems like you have done some tremendous work over the years, according to the past two members who voiced their opinion. It's sad to see you go. I don't know why you're going, but I guess you have better things to do. And I guess the board has already said that they accepted the hard work and dedication you have put into it. So I would side with them, and not even having the opportunity to meet with you, but hopefully, at some point, I'll be able to say hi or hello.
Yeah, I hope to. I appreciate it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Keith?
Yes.
Any comments?
No comments. I would just say we have two openings on the board now, so we should probably reach out to the mayor's office to let them know that we need two members, because right now you need all of the members of the board to be at a meeting to have a quorum.
Frank, we need bodies.
I informed the mayor this morning or this afternoon, so we hope to bring you some people soon.
Okay. Any comments for Dr. Pepin?
No. Just thank you so much for your service. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Okay. Any more business to come before the board?
I just have a question for Keith just regarding the domain for the county.
Yes, I'm working on it, Dennis. And I have to reach out to Ken Fink to make sure they're still interested, because
yes.
He may have moved to California.
Oh, he just emailed me on Tuesday asking.
Okay.
But I'm sorry, what was that, Benny?
Mr. Ken Pick had requested an update on Tuesday. So he's still around as of Tuesday.
Okay, I will finalize that process, because he's actually a friend of mine, and I got an email from him that he moved to California.
Okay.
Oh.
I don't know if he's going to work remotely from the county, for the county still, on a remote basis or what. But that's between him and the county, I guess.
Yeah.
Denny, I don't think we – I'm sorry, Denny, I don't think we took a roll call on that, did we? Accepting the resignation. For Dr. Pepin, I don't think we took a roll call.
No, we did not. Okay. All in favor of accepting Dr. Pepin's resignation?
Aye.
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 Thank you.
Lastly, there is one other issue. Berks County notified us and just basically sent us a forum statement that the skate park down on Canal Street is in conformity with the county's comprehensive plan. So that is just one other thing in the path for the skate park to get, you know, everything in order so they can, you know, at some point break ground. Do you have anything to say about that, Keith?
No, that as you said, that's just a formality. They had to, as part of submitting your plan to the planning commission for the city, you must also submit to the county planning commission, and that's the county planning commission's normal standard review letter. So they saw no problems, no issues. So there's nothing for them to note other than to go forward now through the city's planning commission, which is a little more of an intense process. The county kind of gives a 500-foot view, the city gets into the weeds.
Yes. And there's a lot of weeds down there for them to get into.
Yes.
Okay. Anything else before the board? Hearing none, do I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, guys. I will be talking to you soon.
Take care.
All right, Dr. Pepin, good luck.
All right, thank you.
Take care of my friend.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Take care of my friend.